गुड आफ्टरनून सर, थैंक यू फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग अस द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू इंटरेक्ट विद यू। हियर टुडे वी हैव मिस्टर बीके सिंह, हु इज एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन द कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जीपी पंत यूनिवर्सिटी। सर हैज कंप्लीटेड हिज बैचलर्स एज अ बैचलर्स इन इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम मदन मोहन मालवीय यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी। आफ्टरवर्ड्स सर ज्वाइंड आईआईटी दिल्ली फॉर परसुइंग हिज मास्टर्स इन टेक्नोलॉजी। Sir started his career as a senior research officer in IMS BHU, where he worked for more than 2 years. Afterward, sir joined GP Panch University as an assistant professor in 1991. And from 2001, sir is serving the institute as an associate professor. Sir, we welcome you on our program, Thoughts on Education.
Thank you.
So, sir, we'll start the discussion by our first question. So I would like to know, sir, being the faculty of computer engineering department, what are your roles and responsibilities toward the student?
In my university, the scenario has been changing rapidly down this year, but initially a teacher is supposed to be a role model. He is supposed to be the performer to give an idea to the student how the student should be and what they should aspire for. So we here are supposed to be taking care of students in many roles, and every role demands a different kind of touch. As an instructor of the course, we are supposed to be some sort of abrasive who tries to bring out the best surface out of the students by his academic rigor. But there is another role, advisor to the students, where we are expected to provide the soft touch to the students. If somebody is left behind, we have to encourage him. If somebody is disarrayed or disoriented, then we have to reorient him. And if those who are doing good, we provide encouragement to them. So then there are other academic roles as well. There are some staff counselors who provide the counseling on the particular domain of their activity. And then sometimes they are assigned the duty of hostel wardens. Then there it is again an administrative duty, which brings out the hardness of the teachers to the students. So there are various roles, and you have to make a proper recipe of yourself.
And exactly, sir.
Every teacher is a this of the university for the students. Everybody has his own flavor, his own taste, and his own nutritional value as well. So one professor in my university, used to be the professor, head of department at the time of my joining. He used to say that there is nothing called the ideal teacher. In ideal condition, students should be taught by as many kind of people are in the world. But since they are not possible, so at least our teachers should be of as many kind as many teachers are there.
Great, sir. Great. So, sir, you answered the question very beautifully. Now, moving to next question. How do you try to bring in practical approach towards subject and make it more industry oriented?
This is not your question, but a persistent question before every teacher, because things in industry change rapidly, and particularly in the field of computer engineering and IT, this word rapidly is not enough to describe the changes in computer engineering field. Yes. Because the things in computer engineering and IT changes more rapidly than the word rapid itself.
Exactly.
So this is a major challenge. We try to, and then our approach is, on this issue, we have a long discussion in our faculty. Again, I am quoting the very professor. He used to say, look, we are the people who are making pig iron. Engineering students producing BTEC students, they are the industry just producing pig iron. In iron industry, you know, there are many kinds of manufacturers. There are some manufacturers which produce only pig iron. Then there are some manufacturers who they take that pig iron and produce only steel seeds. Then comes the third level, that there is somebody who is making the stainless steel thali or stainless steel spoon or some stainless steel product.
Yes, sir.
So he used to say that expecting that the first producer will produce the finished product. If we start expecting TISCO Jamshedpur to make spoon itself, it will be tolerated. Similarly, industry should not expect us to produce the student employable in their own processes. We can produce pig iron, BTEC student who is capable in programming, he is analytical, he is skilled in problem solving, and he can fit into any slot provided by the industry. But industry people just think, and we are ready to, if some industry says that you make your curriculum according to our requirement, yes, then we are ready to work as a spoon factory, but then they have to place the order. We need exactly 20 students of this quality, and we will try to produce the 20 exactly. Exactly. But industry don't place order. Industry don't place order. They just demand you should produce the students of their specification and then throw them into the market. And he is not employable for the other enterprise. So I think industry people should forget the getting BTEC students just exactly suitable in their processes. They should require the good engineer, and we must produce the good engineer. This specific piece, you give me the nut bolt of size 3 inch, it is something else. It has to be ordered some other processes. There are some other degrees. Then, but at the BTEC level, I am not convinced to produce the industry compatible students.
Exactly. So, sir, as you were mentioning, preparing student for like your department and your institute focus preparing student for industry ready. So, sir, would you please shed some light on best practices offered by your department to the institute which help them gain necessary skills?
There are many. Some have been limited now, but there we have the courses of different orientation. In the initial phase of their study, we are just interested in, they must be yielding the answer mentioned in the textbook to the examination, so that we can take their rote learning, their commitment to the syllabus, their curriculum. But as the degree progresses, instead of those state-jected answers, we are interested in philosophical answers.
Yes, sir.
Philosophical answer. Our question, we ask the question which don't have the correct answer. They have many answers. They can have many answers, and mm-hmm, all of them are the correct, but they have to tell us the perspective, the situation. What is the situation when this answer is correct?
Oh, Nice.
Because in engineering, there is nothing called correct answer. Okay?
Yes, sir.
You have a macro environment and you have to settle your solution into that macro environment so that it is able to survive the hazards of that macro environment. Okay? If you are crossing the road, car is good.
Yes, sir.
But if you are crossing the river, the boat is good. Neither boat is right, nor car is right. Neither boat is correct, nor car is correct. You just look into the macro environment, then you give me the correct answer.
Yes, sir, exactly.
We try to make it, but it demands the academic independence of the teachers as well, which used to be there in the earlier days of G.V. Pant University, but now it is limited. In those days, in my department, there was a practice. A course used to be Computer System Design 1 and 2. So, design problem was given to all the students. Single problem was given to all the students. They are left free. You have to give the answer after 3 or 4 or 5 days. But the rider was that one answer has only 20 marks. If 5 people have given the same answer, then each of them will be getting 4 marks only.
Oh.
So everybody who is trying to get the full marks has to come with a new solution.
Yes, sir, exactly. That should be unique.
A new solution, which may be correct, may not be correct, but at least you are trying for it. But there is only one correct answer.
Yes.
And everybody has copied that. It means it is the question of 20 marks. So if 20 people has copied it, so
one mark.
One mark. But now we are deviating from there because the number of students and etc. And basically regulatory requirement, because now we are moving towards the external examination system, which
yes,
has a straight-jacketed approach. And a straight-jacketed approach has some framework.
Limitations.
Framework. And frameworks always is against the innovativeness.
But exactly, sir. So,
sir,
talking about current scenario, what are the intervention and approaches you bring in apart from curriculum to train or teach the students?
First, I am always try to break the box. You give your solution, but my approach is, yes, I have a particular problem. You select solution, then I will select the tool. Or you select the tool, then I will select the solution. And then implement it. You know, because nowadays, if I give some standard problem to the students, because we can't say that we are so innovative that we will bring always new problems. And nowadays, information base is so rich.
Yes.
Whatever problem you give, there is a solution available in the cyberspace.
Yes, sir.
So we have to clip their wings this or that way so that the solutions applicable in the cyberspace are somewhat limited.
Yes, sir.
Suppose we know that nowadays most of the solutions are available in C++ and Java, etc. I will just stick to the C. So I expect that for the modern problems, solution in C are not available. But for the old problems, solution in Python is not available.
Yes, sir.
Suppose I am trying to test my friend, then I will give him 8 queen problem to be solved in Python. But I will give him some other problem.
Yes,
graphic
sir.
Design. Graphic design. How a flower blooms or how a manifold moves on the screen. Just write in C.
Oh.
So, I'm not going to claim that I am a very good teacher because we have our own limitations. But we try to break the box and give the liberty to the students.
To think that and... Yes.
We don't have... particularly, I don't attach to the two-hour lab session.
Okay.
Basically, Campbell says that there has to be a two-hour lab class where teacher will conduct the lab class. But I am still in programming. I give assignment while delivering the lecture and tell them you have to program it, design it, etc. You can use that 2 hours.
Yes,
if that 2 hours is sufficient, then okay. Otherwise, you can spend your own hours as well. There is no limitation that you have to work here only.
Yes, sir. Great, sir. So, sir, coming to last question of our interview, what valuable advice would you like to give to the student for them to have a prosperous career ahead?
Don't believe the older people.
Oh.
Am I right?
Sir, it can be both ways. Older people do possess a lot of experience.
They have their fear. The factor of fear is predominant in the old people. A person like me, who dare not to enter prize into the society, and he is still working for last 33 years in a continuous state 9-to-5 job. If I am going to give some advice on the business, I will always give with the pinch of salt of fear. And I do expect I am outdated for those challenges. So, the factor of safety provided by the older are paramount.
Great. Yes, sir.
We have the greater factor of safety. If you are discussing with the person age more than 50, then have faith in his factor of safety. But at the enterprise side, keep him in doubt.
Yes, sir. It has both sided, like it is beneficial as well as harmful. Thank you, sir. Thank you for
your time
and providing us valuable insights.